Ya, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning all students, all the midwife candidate. I'm so happy today that I can meet you, even though only by the videos. Today we will talk about how to read in material in human body. As we know, as a midwife, we should understand, we should figure out how the system in our body is working and what organ that support that system. And what part of the organ that support the organ function, and how the function of that organ, and what kind any problem that can happen on that to that organ? Okay, okay. As we know, we have so many system in our body. Okay, any one of you, can you tell me what the system that we have in our body? Okay, let's see for the next slide. Okay. Okay, and how? What do you see in this graphic, in this picture? We see that there's a circulatory system. Okay, circulatory system is the other name for cardiovascular or for hematology system. Okay. Okay. See, we see this heart is pump the blood to the all of the part of the body. Okay. For the lung, okay, for the body, for the peripheral system, cardiovascular system or hematologic peripheral system, is about digestive system, and the previous one we can see the respiratory system, okay, like this. Okay, we'll see, we have so many system in our body. Okay, can you tell me what system is this? Okay, that's true, this is about musculoskeletal system. This one is cardiovascular, or we can call it about hematology system. This one for respiratory system, this one for digestive, okay? And this one is for endocrinology. This one is about urinary system. This one about neurology, and this one is about integument. Okay, I'm sure that you have already read about it. I'm sure that you have already studied about it. Okay, this one what we call about system, and we know that system is a support. System is a built by the organ, like this one. Yeah, okay, we'll see. This one is there's so many bone in our body. This bone we call it organ or bone. Yeah, this bone is building musculoskeletal, yeah, musculoskeletal system. Okay. And this one we can see the ileum, yeah, this ileum, and then we can see the gastric. It was build the digestive system and the other ends. Okay, we can see that. Okay, so to build a system, it was built by the organ. Okay, and every organ in our body is was a support or built by the part of the organ. Like this one, the example of the part of the organ in respiratory system. To build a lung, to build the organ, lung is built by the alveoli, and then parietal pleura, and then visceral pleura. And we can see maybe when we talk about heart, there's so many part of the organ that's building that organ. Like we can see the left atrium, right atrium, and the other part of that heart. Okay, and then we will talk about function of the organ. Yeah, there's so many function of the organ. Depend what organ of it. In this picture, we can see this was show how the uterus function. Like once we have a labor, this contraction will push the baby, we push the fetus to come out, to birth, okay? And we can see in this another picture, there's a heart, but this heart is very red, it's very red. And the contraction is very fast, okay? Yeah, so there's a abnormality of the function of the heart, okay, or we can see that the heart is having some problems. And now let's see, we have several case in here, okay. Okay, let's talk about this case. Okay, the first case is a pregnant woman came to the midwife with a complaint that when she has uncompleted urine flow, that's mean that when she was urinate, she feel that the urine doesn't flow well. The result of the examination found the physical examination found that there's back knocking pain. So this was a subjective and objective data. The subjective data that the woman say that she has incomplete urine flow. But for the physical examination, for the objective data, we found that by knocking check, knocking examination of the back, a low back, she have a pain on her. Okay. The second case is a third trimester pregnant woman came to the hospital complaining of headaches, blurred vision, heartburn, okay, nausea, and vomiting. And we found that the result of the examination obtained blood pressure, systole, and diastole was 130 and 150 for systole and diastole. Okay, if you can, you have imagination, you can suggest, okay, or you can try to figure out what the case of it. Okay, let's come to the third case. That a mother who is in labor experience, okay, I'm sorry, a mother who is in labor experience strong contraction resulting in additional cervical opening and the advancement of the fetal head. Okay, so we, in this case, in the third case, we see there is a physiology process, okay, physiology process in labor process. When a mother have a strong contraction, it will result in cervical dilatation. So when cervical dilation is complete, we can see that the fetal head will be get out, will be come out. And the fourth case, a postpartum mother has an abundant production of breast milk. You see abundant is melimpah. Okay, mother breastfeed using the correct breastfeeding technique, including positioning, attachment, and being done by on demand. Okay, can you explain what case of it? Okay, this was also a physiology process, physiology condition. It's a normal condition. Okay, it's about how the perfect positioning, how the perfect attachment, how is the on demand schedule for breastfeeding will make the breast milk production is abundant. Okay. Mother was an acceptor of the tubectomy contraceptive method for 10 years, and until right now, she was successfully protected from pregnancy. Okay, this we talk about contraceptive methods. No, we talk about tubectomy, or we can talk about MOA. Okay, the sixth case, a teenage girl injured in promiscuity. You know promiscuity? Promiscuity in Indonesia, we can talk like free sex, okay, free sex. And she got pregnant several times, so sad, and had an abortion. Currently, experiencing lower abdominal pain, currently, yeah, this lately, she had experiencing lower abdominal pain, high body temperature, and leukocytosis, okay, it's a sad case, okay. You see, can you figure out what case of it? Okay, so we have six cases in here that we should solve. We will talk about what system involved, how the system involved, what organ involved, and the other we can talk about the case. Okay. Okay, this one we will talk about the case. Yeah, but before we start to talk about the case, we will see. Yeah. Maybe we need some memory refreshing about human body system, okay? Maybe how the system works, how the organ affect the system, okay? And what the problem can happen to that system, okay? So, the first one, we'll talk about circulatory system, okay? In circulatory system, there's so many organs that involve, like the heart, blood, systemic circulation, pulmonary circulation, and blood vessel. Okay, let's talk about the heart. The heart is a muscular organ at the body midline. At the body midline, you see, at the body midline, okay, in the thoracic region, responsible for pumping of blood in the body. Okay, there is four chamber, which is a right and left atrium, right and left ventricle. And the second organ is blood. But actually, blood is not organ. See, that only a part of the circulatory system, but it was a vital function. Blood, okay? Blood is carries oxygen and nutrients to all parts of the body and regulate the temperature and acidic balance of the body, okay? The systemic circulation, okay, it will carries oxygenated blood, carries the oxygenated blood, okay, from the heart to all parts of the body through of arteries and capillaries, and carries the oxygenated blood from the oxygen from the organ back to the heart through vein, okay? See, in systemic circulation, yeah, artery will carry out the oxygenated blood from the heart to all the body. But the veins, it was a refill. Okay. The vein will bring the unoxidated, yeah, or the oxygenated blood from the organ to the heart. Okay. And then the pulmonary circulation, the oxygenated blood from the body entry into the heart, it pumps to the lung for expelling the carbon dioxide and other impurities and collect oxygen. And the oxygenated blood is sent back to the heart by the systematic circulation. Okay, so we know that oxygen is what's carried out from the pulmonary. When the blood is full with the oxygen, it will carry out to the heart, and the heart will bring it to the all the body system. And then when we talk about blood vessel, we have three blood vessel, okay? The first one is arteries. Arteries will carry oxygenated blood to the different part of the body when the one of the pulmonary loop carry all the oxygenated blood to the lung, okay? Okay, and the vein will carry oxygenated blood from the body and oxygenated blood from the lung into the heart, okay? We'll see the difference of the arteries and the vein function. And capillaries, arteries break down into of capillaries. So we know capillaries is break down from the arteries, which are the smallest blood vessel. It was the smallest blood vessel and is also the most fragile blood vessel. It's easy to break up. It's easy to broke. Okay, but when the capillaries is broken, we found in our body we have so many problems. Okay. Blue or maybe gray in our skin, it will show that our capillaries will break down. Okay, and we'll see the next system in our body. Okay, before we going into the next system in our body, okay, let's try to answer this question. Okay, if someone having diastole rising up, which part of the circulatory system that may cause the problem? Okay. Can you tell me that? Okay. Where we can find the clearest clue of someone heart beating? When we can find, or we can say like a punctum maximum, okay? What is the most clearly punctum we can hear the human heart beating? And the third question is, what is the function of the lung in respiratory system? It's very easy question. It's very easy answer to give it. And you can find it from the before slide, from the previous slide, okay? Okay, the second system is about digestive system. Okay, it will start with mastication, chewing food in our mouth, okay? We have teeth, we have we have so many equipment in our mouth that we're chewing the food, okay? And you will see that the saliva mix with the food and form a bolus. Saliva will mix with the food and form a bolus. Small round mass that can be easily swallowed. So when we eat, our food is joined with the saliva. It will make a small round mass that can be easily swallowed, okay? The food travels down to the oesophagus and into the stomach. Okay? Strong acid and powerful enzyme that break the food into a paste. Okay, after we can make a bolus, we can make a pasta. Okay, or paste. Okay, in intestinal system, yeah, the food is broken down even more. Broken down even more, it means that smaller, okay? It will be smaller, smaller, and more smaller because of the bile secreted by the liver and powerful digestive enzyme from the pancreas. which nutrients are absorbed from the food. The leftover material, or we call it stool, then move on to the large intestine, where it transforms from liquid to solid as water is removed. Okay, as the water is removed. Finally, it gets passed into the rectum, ready to be eliminated from the body. Okay, that was about digestive system. Okay, see this picture, we can see there is a mouth, esophagus, large intestine. Okay, we have 12 part of the digestive system in here. Every part is important. Like in mouth, the most important thing is about saliva. In the gastric, we can see that acid in there will have to change the part which from bolus into the pasta. And in intestine will be important too, because it will make from the pasta part, the pasta, from the pasta into the bile, okay? So every part of the digestive system is important, okay? Okay, so the question for digestive system is the first one, what kind of organ that need for the food chewing? Okay, we already talked about it, and swallowing process. Okay, why saliva is having important role in digestive system? Okay, it's very easy. Okay, in which part of digestive system that may happen constipation? It's very easy too. We can find the answer from the previous page, from the previous slide. Okay, and now we will talk about respiratory system. In respiratory system, there's so many organs here like lungs, nose, larynx, pharynx, trachea, and the last one is bronchial. Okay, the first one we'll talk about lung. Lung or the primary organ, we'll say of our, because there's two lung in our body, of the respiratory system, which have to exchange of gas. Will help to exchange the gas. What gas? Of course, it's oxygen and carbon dioxide, okay? And then the nose. In our nose, we have tiny hair follicle that cover in the interior lining of nostrils, act as the body first line of defense against foreign pathogens. So we have a hair, tiny hair in our nose, okay? It will help to protect from the pathogen, from the microbe, from the virus and the other pathogen. Okay? Nose also provide additional humidity for inhaled air, because in our nose we have mucus. We have mucus, and the mucus is produce some kind of water. It will humidity the air that we pull in our lung. In our lung, okay. And then larynx. Larynx is to cartilaginous cord that lay in the framework of the larynx. It also termed as Adam apple or the voice box, okay? If you ever heard about Adam apple, it's the other meaning of larynx. It is the portion which rise and fall during swallowing of food particle, okay? When we eat something that's moving in our larynx, that was Adam apple, okay? And then pharynx. Pharynx is the epiglottis piece of an elastic cartilago, which serves as a switch between the larynx and the esophagus. Okay, so pharynx is a part between larynx and esophagus by allowing the passage of air into the airway of the lungs and food in the gastrointestinal tract. Okay, and then the fifth part of respiratory system is trachea. Trachea, or the windpipe, rise below the larynx and move down to the neck. The wall of trachea completes C-shape, okay? The trachea having a C-shape. Cartilaginous ring, which give hardness to the trachea. That is, which make the trachea is having a strong condition. It's not easy to break down and maintain by completely expanding. And the last one organ of respiratory system is bronchi, or we can say it's part of the lung. Okay, bronchi is trachea split into the tube termed as bronchi, which enter the lung individually. The bronchi divide into secondary, tertiary, and bronchioles, But it's again filter divide into small air sac called the alveoli. Okay, so we know that alveoli is a part of bronchi. Okay. It enable to exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide molecule into or away from the bloodstream. Okay, into or away from the bloodstream. Question for respiratory system is, what might happen if someone doesn't have the tiny hairs in the nose? Okay, what will happen if we doesn't have tiny hairs in the nose? Okay, and the second question, what might happen if someone having parotid malfunction? Okay, okay, let's understand. Let's remember where's the parotid position? What is the function of the parotid? Okay, we can find the answer in the previous slide. Okay, let's continue to the next slide. Okay, the next system is nervous system. Okay, nervous system contain the brain and spinal cord, while the peripheral nervous system includes nerves and ganglia that are present outside the brain and spinal cord. Through the action, every part of the body get connected. Okay, that was the secret. Okay, and then for brain, it comprises the cerebrum, hypothalamus, and thalamus. The larger part of the brain is cerebrum. Okay, thinking, perceiving, controlling motor function, receiving and processing information, and also understanding language are the main function or the main function done by this section of the brain. Also, sexual development and emotion function are attached to the forebrain. Okay, sexual development and emotion are attached to the forebrain. Okay, and then midbrain. Okay, midbrain. It is situated between hypothalamus and thalamus. The brainstem is associated with the midbrain. Auditory and visual response are controlled by the midbrain. Okay, we see that auditory and visual response was controlled by the midbrain. Then hindbrain. Okay, hindbrain. The medulla, pons, and cerebellum are together tied in the hindbrain. In the connection of the different part of the brain surface that help to accommodate the neuron and connect them to the spinal column are done by the hindbrain too. So important function, okay? Somatic nervous system. The system primary purpose is to transmit the motor and sensory impulse from CNS, okay? CNS, central nervous system, okay? CNS is central nervous system. It's linked all the sensory organ, limbs and skeletal system. And the last one is autonomic nervous system. The system works without the person effort. Okay? How is the system can be work without the person effort? The system have to relay impulse from the central nervous system to smooth muscle and involuntary organs such as your heart and lung. Okay? Heart and lung. And also when we see in labor process, there's uterine contraction, it doesn't need effort from us. It happened by themselves. Okay, it was automatically, okay? Also, it prepared the body against any violent effect or abnormal condition as high body temperature, and also maybe we can be bite by the bug, we can burn by the fire, and the other condition, okay? It was about nervous system. Let's see the question about nervous system. Oh, like you, there is no system for nervous system. Okay, you only need to read the previous slide correctly. Okay, and then this one, female reproductive system. This was the most closest system with our life task, okay? The female reproductive system is composed of a pair of ovaries. There's two ovaries along with oviduct, like tuba, we can call it tuba or salping, vagina, cervix, uterus, and the external genitalia that are located in the pelvic region, okay? Especially when we are not in pregnancy, but when we are in pregnancy, our uterus is going up, get out from our pelvic into the abdominal cavum. Okay. All this part takes process of ovulation, fertilization, but and finally the childcare. Okay. And ovaries. Ovaries act as the main female sex organ that protect the female gamete. Gamete is from a ovarium. Okay. Various hormones. Each ovary measure about 2 to 4 centimeter in length, which is then connect to the uterus and pelvic wall to the ligament. Each oviduct is divided into 3 anatomical regions, which is ampulla, isthmus, and infundibulum. I'm sure that you already understand about it, okay? Uterus. Uterus is also called the womb, okay? Womb, okay? It's a muscular, inverted per shape, origin of the female reproduction system. The wall of the uterus is consists in 3 layers. The inner glandular layer, the middle lytic layer, and the outer thin layer. Maybe we can call it about in endometrium, myometrium, and then the last one is parametrium. Okay, or we can call it in peritoneum. Okay, but the most correctly we can call it. Usually we call it in endometrium, in myometrium. That's 2 part of the uterus. Okay. And then fallopian tube, yeah, fallopian tube or a pair of muscular tube and funnel shape structure extend from the right and left on the ovaries of the superior corner of the uterus to the edge of ovaries. Okay, so fallopian tube is connecting uterus and the ovaries. This tube are enclosed in small projection called fimbriae. You know fimbriae. Fimbriae will swipe over the ovaries to pick up the ovum from the ovaries to supply to bring it to the uterus. Okay. Each fallopian tube is covered by the cilia. Cilia, unicilia. Cilia like a tiny hair in our nose. We call it cilia too. Okay. That function by carrying the ovum to the uterus. Okay, I'm sorry. So cilia will move fastly, and will push the ovarium from the. I'm sorry. Will push the ovum from the ovarium going to the endometrium or to the uterus. Okay. And the last one is vagina. Vagina is a muscular and elastic tube that connect to the cervix. To the external body as a blood canal and also for the menstruation canal. Okay, blood of menstruation will flow through that vaginal tube. Okay. Okay. The next one is a male reproduction system. There is several part of it, which is penis, scrotum, testes, urethra, and prostate. Okay. Penis, it involves three cylindric space of erectile tissue, okay, the two which are larger, the corpora cavernosa lie side by the side to the third one is sinus called corpus penosum covers the urethra, okay, corpus penosum is covered the urethra. The penis become rigid when the space are filled by the blood, or we can say like a man when he makes the reaction for sexual. Okay. Scrotum, it is a sack of thick skin that protect and surround the testes. It also control temperature of the testes since they have to be at slightly lower temperature than the body's temperature for suitable sperm creation. So scrotum is protect the sperm production. Okay. Testes, they are oval bodies, oval, okay, around 1.5 and 3 inch in length. Generally, the left testes hang slightly lower than the right one. Okay, the 2 primary function of the testes was the first one is producing testosterone and producing the sperm. Okay, you know testosterone is the main hormone for the man. Okay, the seminal vesicle are present over the prostate, linked with the vas deferens to create the ejaculatory duct. That travel so into the prostate, okay, to protect the prostate too, okay, because the seminal vesicle is protect some kind of liquid. It will protect the prostate, okay. the seminal vesicle, and prostate generate with nourish the sperm, and both of it will be protect the fluid that will nourish the sperm. So our the man's sperm can be grow, can be mature, and also when the man ejaculate, it can be fertilize the ovum in the woman reproduction system. Urethra. Urethra is a tube-like structure that connect the urinary bladder, to the urinary meatus. Okay, so urethra is connect the urinary bladder to the urinary meatus. Okay, you know urinary meatus. Urinary meatus we call it in kandung kemih. Okay, the prostate exits beneath the bladder and covers the urethra. The prostate grows larger with the age. Okay. If the prostate grows too much, it can block the urinary flow through the urethra and be responsible for some urinary system. Okay, that's all our slide about human body. And I hope you can understand what I'm talking to you. Okay, I hope that you will try to read again, read over and over again. And I'm sure that you will try to answer the question. We have several questions, and I need you to look back for the case. And every case, you should answer it. You should try to find the answer to figure out the case. Okay, like the first case slide, which I will show you the first case again. Okay, let's see. Okay, yeah. Okay, the first case, we'll talk about the first case. I will give you some explanation about the first case, and you will try to give me an explanation in fifth case, in fifth another case, okay? We'll try to read again. A pregnant woman come to the midwife with a complaint that when she has uncompressed urine flow. Okay, the result of the examination, physical examination, found that there was but nothing pain. Okay. Okay, when we see that, we know that the urinary system is responsible for their problem. Okay. Okay, the woman say that when she urinate, she feel that she doesn't have uncompressed flow. So she feel that in her kandung kemih, in her bladder, she feel that there is some urine stay in there, doesn't push out totally. Okay, so that's a problem in her bladder. Okay, and also when we see there's a knocking back pain. Okay, we see that in that part maybe there's a kidney. There's a kidney in there. So when the women feel there's pain for knocking back examination, we suspect that the woman having two infection. The first one in kidney, and the second one maybe in bladder. Okay. As we know, the function of the kidney is to produce the urine and to push to the bladder, and the bladder will push it to come out, okay? In this problem, because the kidney having problem, infection, so there's an inflammation process in there. There's a increasing of toxin produced by the bacteria, and it will, the bacteria, we will increase the toxin of the bacteria, we will increase the prostaglandin in our body. When our prostaglandin is coming up, it will having larger, having a higher level, it will make our cell is contraction, making our muscle is contraction. When our muscle is contraction, we have a lower oxygen for the cell. Unenough oxygen for the cell, it makes the cell having a pain. It causes the pain for the cell, okay? Okay, and then how about the uncompressed urinary flow? Okay, uncompressed urine flow. Yeah, because when we have infection in one organ, it will affect another function. Okay, like we know that the nervous of the kidney will continue, we will connect with the nerves in the bladder. So when the nervous in kidney having problem, and we believe that the nervous in the bladder also is having problem. So when the urethra should be contraction is good, contraction is normal by the affect by the nervous, because the nervous having problem affect from the kidney nervous, it will affect the function of the urethra. So that's explain why the woman having incomplete urine flow and why the woman having knocking back pain. Okay, as the example for the first case, and I need you to try to figure out for the fifth another case. Okay, thank you for the meeting today. We will end it right now. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.